Last day, welcome back. Now see example 17. Previous exercise we saw, previous video we discussed about example 10 and 14. Okay. Now example 17. I'm reading. First part. A lot of 20 bulbs contain 4 defective ones. So number of bulbs 20. Number of defective bulbs 4. Okay. Now see further. One bulb is drawn at random from the lot. Okay. So if any bulb is drawn at random, don't know will it be defective or good, right? Then what is probability that the bulb is defective? Probability of defective bulb. I'm writing B as defective bulb. So how many defective bulbs are there? 4. Yes or no? This is the example of favorable outcomes. That is 4 out of 20. That is 1 upon 1. Right? Now let us take second part. See, listen properly. Suppose the bulb drawn in 1. Suppose the bulb drawn. Drawn means removed in 1. And is not defective. Not defective means what is taken out? Good one is taken out. Okay. So out of 20, 1 is taken out. And they are telling and not replaced. After taking out, not kept back. So in piggy box that in that lot, how many total bulbs are there now? One is removed, that is good one removed. So how many are there now? 19 bulbs. See? So number of bulbs. Remaining equal to 19. Yes or now let us take now what is that question. Now after 19, now one bulb is drawn at random. From that lot, one bulb is taken at random. Okay? Then what is the probability that this bulb is not defective? So how many good bulbs are there? Tell me probability of not defective bulb. Again, this is example of favorable outcome. How many favorable are there in this lot of 19? Not defective means good. How many good are there? 15 are good. So we are writing that is 15 upon 19. Okay? Please listen properly, understand. Undoubtedly, those who are good in English, those who are really understanding English, they will be successful in chapter probability. Probability demands English. Remember it. Now see, example number 23. Example 23. I am reading example 23. See. A game consists of tossing a rupee, 1 rupee coin 3 times. 1 rupee coin is tossed 3 times. Okay? And noting its outcomes each time. One time cross, maybe head or tail, writing outcomes. Okay? So first we'll write how many possible outcomes are there for tossing coin 3 times. See, maybe head or tail. Second time maybe edge or tail. Third time maybe edge or tail. Then see. Number of outcomes are, if I toss one day, all are heads, suppose no, suppose they are HHT, I am not writing bracket, I am writing direct bracket, because we have practiced this, okay? I told you, yes or no? Right? Or if all times it has come here and there, then maybe like this. Second leg, look like this. Okay, or maybe like this. Then see, if we toss 3 times, we are getting such 8 outcomes. Remember, Okay. It's not necessary when I toss three times or they are like this, or they are like this, or they are like this. They may be like this, 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 this. These are all possibilities. Okay. So we how many are possibilities? Okay. Now let us see the example. Honey wins if all the tosses gives the same result. So what is condition for honey? If all tosses are same, then what is possibility of same? Either all are head or all are tail. All outcomes same. So what are they? Either H, H, H or tail, tail, tail. Yes or out of eight. So probability of this event is 1 to 2 upon 8. That is 1 upon 4. Okay. Now let's see. And loses otherwise. If he is getting HST beside this, if they are getting these outcomes, then we will say he is losing. He wins if all outcomes are same. He wins. If all outcomes are not same, he loses. So this is probability of winning. Probability of winning. Okay. Now next see what is that. So calculate the probability that Anil will lose the game. See, probability of event means loss. So now tell me, for how many outcomes there is possibility of losing? He may get lose, loss if this is coming. He may lose if this is outcome. 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 Means number of favorable outcomes which are satisfying the condition that all are not 8 or 10, they are 6. So this probability is 6 out of 8. That is, getting, this is probability of loss. This is probability of loss. Okay, students, now see, please understand this. Read example properly, listen to my video 2 times and solve yourself. Now example 25. See, I am taking example 25. Look here. Which of the following arguments are correct? Interesting. See, which of the following arguments are correct and which are not correct? Some arguments are there. Give reason for your answer. First argument I am reading. See, first one. If two coins are tossed simultaneously, tell me how many possible outcomes are there. Yes, have you tried? Very good. 4 outcomes are there. Two coins tossed simultaneously. Therefore, HH or HT or TH or TT. This is all possible outcome, right? Now let us see further. There are 3 possible outcomes, 2 heads, 2 tails or 1 of each. 2 heads, 2 tails or 1 of each. Yes sir. Now they are asking, therefore for each of these outcomes, the probability is 1 upon 3. If outcome is HS, what is probability? 1 upon 4. If probability is HT, what is probability? 1 upon 4. If it is PH, what is probability? 1 upon 4. If it is PT, what is probability? 1 upon 4. So probability of event is 1 upon 4. Therefore, probability of event equal to 1 upon 3 is incorrect. Students, this is wrong. Understood why it is wrong? Because for each outcome, probability is 1 out of 4. Next, second, see. If a die is thrown, die is having 6 sides, 1 die. There are 2 possible outcomes. See now, first I am writing all possible outcomes. Usually, 1 die is there, what are possible outcomes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are possible outcomes when we throw 1 die. Now let us see what is here. They are telling there are 2 possible outcomes. An odd number or even number. 1, 3, 5, odd. 2, 4, 6, even. Okay. Now therefore, probability of getting odd number. Now, odd numbers. What are odd numbers? 1, 3, 5. How many odd are there? 3 odd. Yes or? How many odd possible? 6. So what is probability of odd? Equal to 3 upon 6. That is equal to 1 upon 2. Yes or? Then see, that is correct. So this is correct. This is correct. Okay, students, see this example of favorable and given correct. My dear, all of you, solve all examples yourself, try yourself. Any problem in exercise 15.1 or some extra examples will be coming in assignment, you will talk to me. Okay, right, and here is the completion of the syllabus here for term 1. Now, I will start giving assignment every day. Maybe 2 assignments per chapter or 3 assignments per chapter. The same day you will complete assignment. And for the doubt in that assignment, you can talk to me anytime. Okay? And students, if notebooks are not checked, internal marks will be given 0. I am telling you. Fine. Just